First of all, I thanks to our management college and thanks to our principal Dr. K. Mani, also our HOD and Dr. S. Murugavalli madam, and all my dear staff members, particularly Sasikumar sir also with here. And also telehealth staff member Vinmadi madam and as well as Anita Moses madam. And a special thanks to all my dear students. You also part of this visit, virtual visit. It is part of your curriculum. I think this visit is helpful for you in all the way. Please, you can interact with your guest. And also I welcome Dr. Sadish Kumar sir. He's a telemedicine head, Department of Telemedicine, Sri Ramachandra Medical College Hospital. So he is always welcoming from our department. Whenever we request for any visit or any help from here, always sir is supporting with us. So I thanks to SRMCH Hospital and as well as particularly telemedicine head Dr. Sathish Kumar. Thank you one and all. We start the session with the presentation. The entire agenda already I shared with you. With first half an hour, there is introduction about telemedicine and how telemedicine department is functioning here. And Sathish Kumar sir presenting first half an hour. Then there is interaction session with the students in next half an hour. So please, you can interaction with the sir and switch on your mic and as well as turn on your video. Then next half an hour is entire visit to this department. So all the device which you are theoretically we are discussing, that can show here. Thank you, one and all. Thank you, madam. Sir, thank you, sir.
Thank you,
sir. Sathish Kumar, sir. Thank you.
Good morning, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Good morning, one and all. Greetings from Sri Ramachandra Medical College and University. Sir, give your permission to for my PPT to share my PPT.
Kuduthirukku, sir. Ninga share kudunga, sir.
Yeah.
Click share option, sir.
Good afternoon, one and all. Good morning to one and all. Greetings from Sri Ramachandra University. And this is our small setup at telemedicine center, which was taken a long back 10 years ago. And this is a Pan-African studio project of our medical center, exclusive for the African countries. And the studio room as well as the production control room of our Pan-African project, where I'm sitting and delivering lecture. And the objective of this paper is, what is telemedicine? How does it work? And the technologies used in telemedicine, as well as telemedicine applications, particularly in teleradiology, telepathology, telecardiology, and teleneurology, which is a very commercial aspects, commercial viable projects, where we can play a lot for commercial revenue. And robot for ICU patients management, as well as robotic surgery. And before this, let me introduce about the role of telemedicine at HRMC. It's the first international multi-conference and tele-education program, which was first time in the country in the year 2001, connecting four countries from India, like Singapore, Japan, Hong Kong, which was a great success. Technically, there was some problem, but its concept was very good, introduced by the Professor Tetsuo Kannu, who treated our former Chief Minister Dr. M.G. Ramachandran. This was well published in papers and magazines, which motivated Ramachandra Institution to start telemedicine in a better way. Then we officially started telemedicine in 2002 by Honorable Minister of Malaysia. So ISRO came because telemedicine connectivity is very important. ISRO came into the picture and agrees to provide teleconnectivity around 300 centers across the country in joint venture with the ISRO, Government of India. Ramchandra Medical College was chosen as a first tertiary care center to provide GB Panth Hospital, where they don't have a super specialty services. In fact, this was inaugurated by then Prime Minister of India, Dr. Atal Bihari Vajpayee in the year 2002. And Ramchandra Telemedicine has done one more pilot project, an important project in association with ISRO and SRMC. That's called the Village Resource Program in 2004. Again, this was inaugurated by then Prime Minister of India, Dr. Manmohan Singh. And we have taken variety of projects in telemedicine. So let us introduce about telemedicine. What is telemedicine? If you surf in Google, you may have plenty of definition from ATA, American Telemedicine Association, or Telemedicine Society of India, or Wikipedia. But I would like to say in a single sentence or single line, it's a practice of medicine over distance through telecommunication equipments. It's nothing but whatever the traditional way they do practice telemedicine, it can be done in medicine, it can be practiced in telemedicine also. What they do in the traditional way, like a consultation, diagnosis, therapies, medical management, and surgical management. For consultation, the patient can come and discuss with the doctor to consult regarding health issues. For diagnosis, the doctor is checking the BP to diagnose whether he is a hypertensive patient or not. The medical staff checking the temperature for the patient, whether he has a, she has a fever or not. And this doctor examine oxalate, that heart as well, lung, whether they have any problem on that organ. Similarly, therapies like speech therapy or occupational therapy or physiotherapy, they do. These can be conducted in telemedicine also. And medical management, prescribing, as well as examining the patient and prescribing, as well as surgery is being done in the traditional way. The entire thing can be done in telemedicine nowadays. The first and foremost important question, why telemedicine, particularly in countries like India? Mr. Doctor show recommend at least for the one doctor to 1,000 patients. But in India, we have 1:1,500 approximately. Just to imagine about the doctors, particularly in the super specialty like a cardio, who treats that heart, and hepatology exclusive for that liver disease, and neurology who treats that brain disease and diagnosis and disease, and as well that surgical. These super specialty doctors are not available across the country. Particularly, they are available only in metropolitan city as well capitals of states. But you imagine, when the patient from the taluk or village level, if they have any problem on cardiac or brain or intestine problem or rheumatoid problem, it's too difficult to meet the doctors in specialist centers. So in this situation, telemedicine play a major role by providing teleconsultation services as well examining the patients. And we divide the telemedicine center into mainly two groups. One is a patient end, another one doctor end. Other is called specialist end. What is patient end? The patient end, for example, there is a district hospital or taluk hospitals, or even from your home where the patient sits and expecting the expert's opinion. That's called patient end. The doctor's end, in the sense of where the doctors are sitting or specialists are sitting to provide opinion to the patient. That's called doctor's end. For example, patient end, I may example, there is a district hospital in Nagapattinam or Kolkata or Siliguri or somewhere else. Doctors in the example, maybe for Madras Medical College or Ramchandra Medical College or Panimalar Engineering College in future, or Panimalar Medical College in future. So telemedicine, an innovative field of medicine, is expanding dramatically worldwide. It enables clinical expertise to be provided where there are doctor shortage, primarily in rural area clinics and hospitals. In India, large academic institutions have already started using telemedicine, have been for last two decades. It's practiced in many parts of the world, depending upon the needs of the each country, because the telemedicine can be, it has a variety of applications and it has a variety of role to be played in telemedicine. But it can vary from the, depends upon the country's need. It can be real time or store and forward method. Real time in the sense of the video conference telemedicine activity, where the both the doctors can sit and can discuss on behalf of the patient. And the store and forward method in the sense of for getting opinion on some imaging, for example, Middle East countries or some other countries in they have that hospital India, that's called the store and forward method, other is called the offline method. In telemedicine, due to time difference between the countries to country, the next day or evening the doctors can see the images in India, they can provide the result for that imaging. That's called store and forward method. In many countries, they practice telemedicine exclusively for the particular applications like telecardiology, teleneurology, teledermatology, telepsychiatry and teleradiology as well. And many advanced countries started telemedicine in home-based monitoring. In developing country like India, we are using telemedicine exclusively for that super specialty opinion. That is called the providing expert opinion. What are the essential equipments for telemedicine setup? We can divide into three categories. Number one, video conferencing setup. Number two, communication line, which is the backbone in telemedicine. The third one, hardware and software for image acquiring, viewing, as well transferring. Let us see the video conferencing. You may be aware of that. It consists of the video conferencing camera. It's not a video camera, video conferencing camera. It can act, it can be the IP address can be assigned, it can act as a node. And TV and monitors as public address system, like include mic, speaker, amplifier and mixer for both audio as well video. This is a small setup, which was, this photo was taken 15 years before at our telemedicine center. And communication line, a variety of communication lines are there, including the direct satellite connectivity of which was provided to ISRO and many other private companies also. And ISDN line played a major role 10 years before, not nowadays because of that expensive. And as well that broadband has come in a better way recently. And since telemedicine functions as an independent office, you should have dedicated computer, scanner, flatbed as well, transparent printer, fax machine. Nowadays, bundled things are, it's a single machine can act as a printer, scanner, photocopier, fax, and telephone. The scanner, there are two variety of scanner. One is a flatbed scanner and transparent scanner. The flatbed scanner can be used for the scanning that document as well the photo. The transparent scanners can be used for the negative image like X-ray, CT scan, MRI. And wireless router as well that PSTN lines. The software, particularly for that, since it's functioning as a office, it should have that the MS Office or whatever it may be. Although special software for telemedicine consists of that DICOM Weaver and HL7 standard. A company, few company name like a Televatel, Prognosis or OTR, Vipro, Sanjeevani, HCL, etc. Recently Tata came into the picture. So what are the common benefits in telemedicine? Just when you talk about the common benefits, you could have seen it avoids travel time. Environment travel drastically both for doctors and patients, but helps good revenue to any hospital when they start telemedicine. Also, we can say that telemedicine is the third gateway to any hospital. Also, it increases the patient's flow and variety of cases across the country, continent or globe, depends upon the facility you have. In fact, fastest way of meeting doctors for diagnosis or treatment plan. So unless you have telemedicine, too difficult to tell the thing. It is the best way of for promoting doctors and hospital to the patients community, in also meeting the stalwarts or doyens in the field. These are the common benefits in telemedicine. And if you ask the questions for hospital, what are the common benefits to the hospital? So on behalf of you, let me raise the thing. Will, sir, anything you'd like to ask? Because I am hearing some other noise. Will patients flow increase, or is it source for direct or indirect revenue? Is it way of gathering patients from across the country, or sharing knowledge at low cost with less expense to the doctor? Is it true? I can put yes to almost all questions. Similarly, are there chances for meeting stalwarts? Name and fame to the doctor institution, is it true? Yeah, that's absolutely right. The role of telemedicine, we can use the telemedicine for the three major components. One is for the patient's care, the second one academic activity, the third one research and training. For patient's care, you can use the teleconsultation, telediagnosis, expert's opinion on super specialty services or multi-specialty services like cardio, neuro, nephro from one point to another point. Also public awareness program, maybe this doctor is sitting and delivering lectures to the many villages. And post-operative case follows, which I can show you in a couple of slides. And case discussion, in the sense of complicated or interesting cases can be discussed among the doctors. Everything comes for that. We have mobile telemedicine in our Ramchandra also. Throughout the country, there are only the 12 mobile telemedicine units are functioning, in which Ramchandra is also one among them. Also, international consultations or meeting, as well teleradiology, telepathology, as I mentioned that earlier. Also, ICU monitoring by using telemedicine, by using the robo, also for patient's care. How does it works? I can give a small example. How does telemedicine works for the patient's care? As I mentioned, there are two end. One is the patient and doctor end. At the patient end, the local doctor or staff or nurse or paramedics collect the patient's relevant data, including the past clinical history, present medication, treatment detail, and investigation reports and images like X-ray, CT scan, MRI, etc., or ECG, EEG, etc., and transfer that to the specialist end by accessing the server, either online or offline. Also request an appointment from the experts of the concerned department, maybe a day before or 2 days before or 1 week before, or at times on spontaneously immediately for emergency cases like a road traffic accident or emergency on high risk delivery. This is the operational patient end. It can be sent. For example, this photo represents one of the teleconsultation during. This is a doctor from one of the patient end. This is the patient, collect the patient data and already send it to our institution and fix the appointment. The next day, specialist from the neurology came and scrutinized the patient and the patient data and gives opinion. So both then doctors should be there, but in India, we entertain the doctor should be there for smooth functioning. And the specialist end, if it is an online teleconsultation, as I mentioned earlier, there are two kind of category. One is that online teleconsultation, another one is the offline teleconsultation. Online is that video conferencing. Since the video conferencing is a fascinating in telemedicine, we use the video conferencing. The doctor at the remote site, that's called patient end, will present the case orally to the expert. Then the specialist doctor will scrutinize the patient's case history and see the images, if any, finally give his or her opinion what to be the best to the patient. If it is offline, I mentioned CT scan or morning time to where is that India time will be the night, and they may go for that rest. The next day, it will be morning in India, the night will be there in that night. The doctor can see that images like CT scan, MRI, and based on that important finding, they can type the reports and sent to the server in the TS. This is called offline. This picture represents this was taken during teleconsultation. This is Dr. S. Thanigasalam, who is the eminent in cardiologist in India, having that 50 years plus experience in teaching as well research in medical. Still, is 55 plus years experience in clinical practice. Still, he practice. So he does the consultation. During consultation, check the BP and ECG of everything. Online ECG can be done. I show the equipment also later. And this picture represents the post-operative case follow-up of plastic surgery, where the patient got admitted in Ramachandra from Northeast, that's in one of the states in West Bengal. After operation, the patient has to come for review after 2 weeks. But instead of coming all the way from their hometown, they can go to our own center, telemedicine center. There will be a medical officer will be there. He can examine the patient and present the case. Before that, the supporting document can be sent already, and they can mention the patient hospital ID. We can access our server to log in, check the what was the operating procedure and course in the hospital. It will be very useful to the patient. Otherwise, they have to travel all the way, and they save that huge money also. Exclusive for both center doctors. Saw this is from Siliguri near Darjeeling. This is from Kolkata doctor. On behalf of the patient, the doctors can present at the from the both center, and experts is a professor in orthopedic who operated the patients, came and giving opinion what to be next done. That's called a post-operative. Also, telemedicine plays a major role in disaster management, like a landslide or tsunami or some other thing. This picture was taken a long back in 2008, the last tsunami, which was hit a major problem in the Port Blair as well, the Andaman and Karnikubar Island, where they lost the entire electric power as well communication line. But fortunately, that both hospital, this is called GB Pant Hospital, one of the major hospital. Now it became a medical college in Andaman. This is the BJR Hospital in Karnikubar. Both center telemedicine, both institution have the telemedicine center, which was inaugurated by, as I mentioned, that then Prime Minister of India, Dr. Atal Bihari Vajpayee, between Ramchandra and Andaman Nicobar Island. During tsunami, the entire connectivity was lost, no power, and that the island was disconnected virtually from that because of this thing. But fortunately, they have the connectivity, satellite connectivity was there, they have the UPS, they connected Ramchandra for getting opinion regularly, periodically. After stabilize that power and other things for the day, evening, then they started the activity. So that person played a so far we have done the for I explained for that the patient's care. Let us see for how the telemedicine can be used for academic activity. Since Ramachandra is that academic institution, we have the medical college, dental college, physiotherapy college, pharmacy college, etc. We organize regularly CME or conferences, which can be telecasted to other medical colleges. So what is the benefit for that's called, we can say the CME programs. We can say CME. CME stands for Continuing Medical Education Program, which is very mandatory to practice the doctors to attend the CME program. Nowadays, that the Minister of Health and Family Welfare, as well as the Medical Council of India, put an order to attend that every doctor, even that who practiced private practice at the village, they should attend that CME program, because CME, by adding CME, by conducting CME as well, attending CME, the credit hours can be given to the doctors. Since ours is academic institution, we are organizing very many conferences. Terminology will be differ, like physicians conferences, surgeons forum, grand round meeting, clinical society meeting, tumor board meeting, exclusive for oncology, and workshops as well, guest lecture, where we have the eminent speakers across the globe, and the live surgical demonstration, where we cannot allow many doctors or medical professionals or nurses in the OT. So the live surgery, whenever they do that very complicated or very interesting or very rare surgery, can be telecasted through telemedicine to other medical colleges or inside college also. For example, there is one cardiac transplant or liver transplant can be performed in a major hospital. So we cannot accommodate, we cannot accommodate many people there inside OT, but our general surgeon or junior doctors, they would like to see how the operation was performed or is being performed. So by using this telemedicine, we can relay that entire audio video, including the dual interaction, can be possible to the doctors. And virtual reality as well, simulation practice exclusive for the student, I mean for surgical student to learn a lot. This picture and from Ramachandra, we have telecasted many CME program, nearly about 3000 CME programs or conferences across the country. University. This was taken almost 12 years before, where rapid review course of general surgery organized. It's from RIMS Imphal, one of the biggest medical institution in North India, as well Andaman. Before this program was, this picture was taken before program starts. And you can see that how interested many students are standing there, since we couldn't expect so much students will come because of the interest of the topic also. Meeting the stalwarts for nephrology. We telecast our international CMA program to the various leading institutions across the globe, like Harvard University, New York University, University of Southern California, as well Russia and Italy. Research and training. So the telemedicine plays a major role in patient care as well academic activity by telecasting or sharing the CMA program or conferences. Similarly, the research and training is played. It will be very useful for your area, because in R&D will be done in future, because invention of new equipments as well, developing new software for image occurring, image transferring or image viewing, also for developing software like HIS, I mean hospital information system, or electronic medical record or health record or fax or pixel archival communication system, or including the DICOM viewer. Training to the engineering or management students also done in telemedicine. The R&D, I would like to mention here, because when I joined here 18 years before, the telemedicine started in a very big institution like Ramachandra, Apollo, or Amrita University, or Gangaram Hospital, New Delhi, or AIIMS, New Delhi. But many institutions, telemedicine is to be installed or started at many, even small institution or even small clinic. But 15-20 years before, many people hesitate to start the telemedicine due to various reasons. Particularly, it needs huge investment to procure the camera, high-end camera, satellite connectivity. Even though some of the funds have been released from the government of India as well, connectivity was given. But one thing I would like to mention here, 18 or 20 years before, the software played a major role exclusive for that. Many institutions unable to afford that software, because when the softwares are developed by international centers like German or hello, so it records that many huge investment for software. Recently, last 5 to 7 years, many Indian companies started practicing developing software. And we welcome your students like you in your tenure, after you completed or during your end of that course, you can develop software for telemedicine, which includes that you can consider HIS, EMR to be integrated in telemedicine, as well new equipments. You could have seen, and 10 years before there were no smartwatches or no any equipment there. But recently, many Google have played a major role developing the medical equipments. So in your future, just you can do many R&D in your invention of new equipments. Teledentistry, similarly, we have been keep on talking of telemedicine. Then based on the success of our telemedicine thing, our dentist or our dental college doctors and faculties, they wanted to utilize telemedicine in a major way. Also, they started practice. So let me brief about a couple of slides about teledentistry. This was one of the inauguration of CMA, CDE programs. Similarly, CDE stands for Continuing Dental Education Program, like a CME. It tie up with the Amrita University, one of the major university in South India. We regularly organize that conferences where he is at Dr. Prem Nair, who is the director of medical college, and he is the principal of dental college, where our dean is sitting here and introducing the program. The students of dental community, they start the, getting benefited. You can see that doctors community, the dental community, dentist community from the various super specialist department like periodontics and orthodontics, they do regular program. And oral pathology is called oral pathology. They organize periodically slide seminar program. So complicated or interesting cases can be slide, can be viewed and can be examined by the experts. So these programs can be shared directly from the microscope from the dental college to across the other institution. We have been about nearly about 50 slide seminar program on oral pathology between Ramachandra and Amrita over 8-10 years. Also, our dental program started delivering lecture to the Africa. Even this picture was taken when our HOD of oral pathology delivered lecture to that Africa. The Egypt doctors from Egypt, they are participating. Also, for social cause, our dental organizing their many camps in various places. And it's a periodontics. That's called periodontics exclusive for the patients. The patients from the pediatric age group. That's called periodontics. They treat the patient. They organize the camps in various places in schools also. What they do, they utilize telemedicine. Every year they organize a camp. They utilize telemedicine. Instead of visiting that particular school or thing, they can virtually meet many schools at a time, and they take classes by using that animation, presentation, interaction, and a small demonstration, including demonstration. This picture represents that this for teledentistry practice. You can see the Chennai Public School also joining, and doctors, faculty from the dental, particularly for the pediatric department or periodontics department, they deliver the lectures. And it will be very useful to the student because oral hygiene is very important. There are two groups. One is that geriatric group, just which is the 65 plus or 60 plus, who is having the more prone to the oral hygiene. The next one, the age between the 3 years to 8 years. So when we teach or make awareness about that oral hygiene to the student when they are the school student or nursery or primary school student, it will be very useful to the student, for human being. The doctors can, because they consume a lot of chocolates and ice creams, they're more prone to the oral disease. That's why the periodontists regularly organize the camps through telemedicine. And this picture was taken about again 8 years before, where the international contest in telemedicine dental college, they approached us. They supposed to give a lecture in London, which is organized by Johnson & Johnson, unable to go there personally. The last moment they asked us, a week before they asked us, just we also participate through telemedicine. And one happy news, just we won the first prize in that entire throughout the world contest. Also, tele-nursing, apart from the telemedicine, teledentistry, our tele-nursing also being practiced in telemedicine. Usually, countries like US, their nursing role is very important in telemedicine, because most of the telemedicine center, home-based monitoring, the nurses are regulator to provide or bridges to connect the patients as well the doctors. for what diagnosis, which doctor to be communicated, they'll be sitting in that hub, telemedicine hub, and they scrutinize the cases and they assign the cases to the concerned hospital, concerned doctors. But it's not being practiced in India. But also we practice telemedicine for nurses in a different way, because the Ramch, our institution, for example, we taking classes to increase the standard of the other hospitals nurses. Since our nurses, since Ramchandra is accredited institution internationally, like NAC or JCAA, as well NABH and NABL, the nursing staff management if the other institution would like to request us. This picture taken from the G8 Government Hospital, Neyveli. Lecture is being taken from our institution, and which was participated with many nurses in that GHNLC. This photo also for one other thing. This is for Sriharikota, where they are running a small hospitals for the entire island on Andhra Pradesh. They are also participating in our lectures by using the satellite connectivity, which was provided by ISRO. So let us see what we do in India as well, what we are other institutions are doing. So you could, as I mentioned, almost all these things, case discussion, teleconsultation, post-operative case follow-up lectures for that patients come connectivity, as well that for patients care, as well academic institution like a CME, CDE or conference, live surgery, mobile telemedicine, as well disaster management by using the mobile telemedicine or tsunami or landslide, etc. But internationally, whatever we do in India, they also do. Apart from that, they use that specific applications like a teleradiology, telepathology, telepsychiatry, and home-based telemonitoring, and ambulatory care also can be done. Institution. I know drones. In couple of departments, one floor, and a couple of departments, another building. So the doctor wants to visit from one floor to another floor by, or one floor, one building to another building, or third patient, the third building. It's too difficult. It takes a lot of time to for traveling alone. So instead of that, the doctor can come and sit in his chamber. From the chamber, he can operate the robo. The robo can go to the particular patient ward, a particular patient's bed. And the robo consists of that video conferencing. Even Ramchandra also has a robo also, but we are not using for the ward round, it's using for the ICU management. The doctor can operate the robo. The robo can go to the particular bed, and he can see the patient's vital parameters, as well the imaging, what is the present condition, what is the dosages was given to the patient also. Then he can interact with the patient if the patient is not in ICU, as well that nursing staff can help to the patient, and they can, on behalf of the patient, nurse can interact with the doctors for further management. It's being practiced in many hospitals in US. And robot reception, because you could have seen in many IT company, they are using the paperless office. So they don't use any paper, even for the invoice or attendance or anything, they don't use the paper. Everything is a biometric system, or everything is IT and other communication systems are used for that, maintaining their office. So in many hospitals in US, they use that robo for ICU, at reception. The reception, as soon as the patient comes, they scan the patients, and because it's and centralize that patient data throughout the country. So it can biometric system by scanning their finger or eyeballs, or then it can provide the coming, or what kind of disease for the medicine or dermatology, or maybe interact with the patient and collects the data, and it can it's maybe for registration. Then after that, it can guide. You have to wait, go to the sixth floor or fifth floor or third floor for particular department. So the robot plays in the hospital exclusive for the reception. And robotic surgery, maybe it's very fascinating, one of the advanced technology in telemedicine, medical industry, where the doctor can sit anywhere in the world, he can operate a patient where they may be there. The robot can perform a surgery based on the instruction given by the doctor by using the Da Vinci. I mean, even just we had given a demonstration in India in 2002 itself. And in India, many hospitals started practicing robotic surgery, not periodically. So we can see the what is the medical legal issues in telemedicine. If you want, just I can explain. But generally, we use the MOU consent forms and strictly following standard guidelines for Government of India, as well as senior faculty to avoid their medical legal cases, who can scrutinize the cases very strictly. So technology, as I mentioned, that there are plenty of technology is being used in telemedicine, exclusively the students, like because as I mentioned, the telemedicine can be divided into two groups. One is a patient and another one is a doctor end. So anyhow, the equipment plays a major role helping that medical industry. The manpower, the doctor end, the manpower will be the ideal candidate will be that the IT background or electronic background or biomedical computer science background or biomedical students will be ideal candidate to run the show, because we deal with the communication line, satellite connectivity, or video conferencing camera and the network switch and hub, other things also. Mobile telemedicine by using the satellite connectivity, telerobot technology, as I mentioned in the previous slide also, virtual reality technology for surgical training or simulation practice is nothing but we can say in the video game kind of things. We can, this funnily, we can say in the medical doctors, simulation practice is a high technology, but we may say it's nothing but it's like a video a game in the 3D, three dimension. But it's very important for the surgeons. The physician can learn a lot. Even suppose if they touch the patients, 1,000 or 2,000 patients, over a period of time, he may gain a lot of experience in physician. But surgical, he cannot do all the practice on live. So which will give the simulation can give you a good practice to the surgical student. And imaging technology, the PACS or DICOM, the PACS CT can be connected to the that image telemedicine server across the globe, not only for a particular institution. Also, special software in telemedicine application where many of I hope many of your students will develop in telemedicine software in future also. And we also introduced a robo for which was first time in the country for ICU monitoring, which was inaugurated by former President of India, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. This technology, again, let me explain another good technology. There is an PhD candidate who performed a PhD in telemedicine, particularly for the audiology. There is an equipment procured from US, which was first time in the country, which was funded by the Government of India, ICMR, Indian Council of Medical Research. So it was a very awesome project where the audiologist or speech pathologist can visit many villages and collect the neonatal as well the pediatric is then 5 years, and he can check the ears and any slurring on speech or slurring on speech or the etc. He can from there by using that equipment, you can see the equipment which can be connected here and on patients. It can be transferred through the satellite connectivity of ISRO to Ramchandra. Our ENT surgeon can check entire parameter and for giving diagnosis. That was very massive project, and she was awarded a PhD also for first time in the country. This is a mobile van we had used. And we had done it, the Pan-African telemedicine project, which was a major telemedicine project in the country. Whatever we do in India, both for patient care and incident, he announced in Africa, Johannesburg, that India will support entire continent, all 53 member countries of Africa, both for medical as well education purpose. So in India, about 10-12 medical colleges have been chosen as a super specialty services, and Ramchandra was one among them. Provide that consultation as well CME program. We have telecast about 540 conferences exclusive for Africa in many countries like Ghana, Gambia, Djibouti, Ethiopia, Sudan, Libya, etc., Nigeria. Also in telemedicine, we do a lot of students are coming from the various department, almost last 15-16 years. It's for that engineering student, I believe so, and MSc audiology students who are posted in telemedicine. And nursing students also, because they in future telenursing will be in a major place, a major role. It's another batch of nursing, and MBA students of our university, and again MBA students of the sports medicine students. So we started sports medicine, and they are also posted in telemedicine. How? Because as I mentioned that earlier, how the therapy can be done, the therapies can be done through telemedicine. This is another batch of from VIT. This is also another batch in EAT. And we have done our telemedicine is that I'm happy to say there are two PhD candidates enrolled in telemedicine last in 10 years before we have grown up like this. And they have completed their PhD, I think. One of the PhD guide is Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. Before he had a meeting for exam. And many VIP visits telemedicine center is Kasturi Rangan, who was that pillar in telemedicine when he was chairman of ISRO, he inaugurated telemedicine center between the Ramchandra and Andaman, who after recently he visited the Ramchandra center, how does it functioning with Andaman. Also that managing director of Kundai visited our telemedicine center along with the mobile telemedicine, because that mobile telemedicine was funded partially by the Kundai Medical for their who adopted many 22 villages in and around Kundai Motors, who visited also our institution, President Program for Telemedicine. I'm happy to, thanks for listening. I'm happy to answer any question if you have.
Anita Moses, Sasikumar sir. Students, please be if any students want to ask any question, madam sir, ready to, the presentation is over. Next 5 to 15 okay. minutes interact with Dr. Sadhi sir. Isaac,
okay. Students na idhila WhatsApp la
idu, yes ellarum please switch on your turn on your video, those students who are wishing to ask question.
Switch on your camera.
Can you ask question? Isaac, any students?
Hello, sir.
Yes, if you have any doubts, any students ask question.
No, I have no doubts, sir.
Okay.
Thank you. It's too difficult to ask, and most of the people also won't explain. So under the student category, just you can raise, feel free to raise any question. Let us see.
Girls, what about you, Bhairavi?
Please,
Vidyadarshini, Indumati, have any doubts you can ask, like what are the other things, like sir told, no, like you have any doubt. Certain concepts we have told, the technical part sir has told many details. You can ask any doubt.
Yeah, you can raise technical question also, because this I am right, in fact.
Amir Mugundan,
good morning sir. Yes, morning. Sir, I have a doubt, sir. What are the medications you have been taking for to improve your security, sir, since you take up most of the operations and using telecommunication lines? So how do you manage the security of those lines, sir? Is there a particular team behind it, or it is as it is?
Well, can you switch on your camera?
Camera.
camera and speak. So interaction always, everybody want to know you who are asking question. No? Please switch on. Okay. Yes, very good. Tamir, good morning. Muhammad Tamir, good morning. 306, very
morning, sir.
Good morning.
What I understood, what are the medication you want to administer to the patient, or what is the security you want to?
No, sir. You said that you carry out all the telecommunication operations using communications lines, right? So, of course, we'll be having a very big network inside your college, right? Inside your center. So, how secure is that network, and what are the steps you have been taking to protect that network? Is there a particular security team for that, management team for that? That's
my yeah, you can say, we are safe, our data cannot be stolen, number one, generally we may say, but anything can be transferred through net, can be hacked. Technically it will be possible, to steal the data when you transmit from one to another end. When you are in online, that's technically possible. But what we do on behalf of the patient, doctor will be the remote side. Yeah, in his concern, just he can send a prescription.
Okay.
We may not say we are very safe. We may not say we are very safe and the data cannot be stolen. Certainly it can be possible. But we should, at the same time, we should protect our data, ensuring that firewall and the authentication by accessing user ID and password for concerned patients.
So, do you have a particular team behind it, or it's provided by some other third party vendors, sir?
Yeah, for Ramachandra, we have our own team. But many institutions nowadays, last couple of years, and nowadays, use a centralized based software. Many institutions like district hospital or taluk hospitals, they need not buy the software. The software can, for example, there is a Tata, they want to provide a license to the particular hospital. They can access server of telemedicine server, which is located in the Tata head office, and access through the use authentication, the institution by doctor as well by institution, they can do it. So the data security, privacy to be taken care by the Tata institution. Similarly, just I'm telling the name. Similarly, many institutions they started practicing. But in our practice, like a televital or OTRI or whatever it may be, that like prognosis, they install the software at Ramachandra, because it's a Ramachandra or Apollo, whatever it may be. The software will be there. We have to maintain that secret at our patient security at our level.
Yes, sir. I have another question, sir. Recently, due to the intervention of Da Vinci robots, laparoscopy has been abandoned, right? So, is laparoscopy still being used in the industry? Is it still being used by doctors today for some situational cases?
Yeah. See, the law, recently I have read that article. Since I am that one of the executive committee member in that national level, absolutely right. It should not be banned, abandoned. But what, due to some other reason, it was abandoned, number one. And second thing, you cannot restrict the doctor to do. You have to maintain the proper MOU or agreement with the other institution to practice in your level, number one. And second thing, you have to practice the proper, strictly follow the proper guidelines of the Government of India, as well as the Medical Council of India, For example, in India, I'm talking about that thing. Whatever you do, practice the ethical practice in your regular traditional way, the same has to be prayed some more. In fact, you have to more cautious when you practice in telemedicine also. If you follow the strict rules and the regulations, as well recently, there is an guidelines have been released. Preliminary guidelines have been released last March 25th in the Government of India, Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. So if you strict, they mentioned the various category, including that what are the drugs can be prescribed through telemedicine. So we have to follow the strict for procedure so that you can, you will be in safer hand.
Yes, sir. So I have one more question, sir. Last one, sir. I hope I'm traveling.
No, please.
Yeah. So what is the success ratio of the telemedicine operations in Ramachandra, sir?
No, success ratio in the sense of telemedicine operation, you are talking about the exclusive live surgery or overall teleconsultation, robotic and other things?
No, sir. The live surgeries which are used using telecommunication.
See, here there is a question whether not regarding that surgery. See, generally, since I'm not a medical professional, I can comment, I don't know whether I'm right or wrong. Usually, the doctor says, after surgery, surgery is success. Okay, next sentence, you can fill it up. Number one.
It is, and second, yes, sir. Yes, yeah, it is applicable for even...
technical also.
Not only in the technical, even the doctor is doing without telemedicine also. Whether the success or failure, it depends upon the patient condition, all those. God only.
Yeah, but mostly this live surgery comes, there are two things, live surgery. Number one is that live surgery is being telecasted, complicated or interesting cases can be telecasted for the learning purpose or teaching purpose among the doctors, number one. So there is no question that a patient is a success rate or not something. Suppose when you do a practice like a remote telesurgery or robotic surgery, then the question will be applicable, number one.
Yes, sir. Yes, very good. Thank you, Tamir. Please switch thank over you, to sir. Other students. Girls.
Sir, one doubt. Sir.
Yeah, yes, please. Isaac, welcome.
Sir, one doubt, sir. Sir,
on your, during on the your presentation, camera, yes, on your on camera, and ask.
Camera, then talk to sir. He freely you can.
Sir, one doubt, sir.
Sir, Isaac, you please switch on. Yes, welcome. Yes. Now it's okay.
Hello, sir.
Yes, switch on your camera. Then speak.
Just a minute, sir.
Yeah. Just you give over the turn on camera, that symbol. Then speak. Isaac.
Sir,
Isaac, then
it will be too awkward to them. So you need not switch on the camera, sir. Because maybe
you're
in home. So we don't know.
No, Sathya, sir. What I feel is in the regular class also, they won't switch on the camera, sir. So we want to also see them.
It is a universal thing,
sir. Sir, ask
hello,
question.
Sir.
Yes.
Hello, sir. Sir, one doubt, sir. Sir, during the presentation session, you mentioned about some software, sir, like Sanjeevani and other like Televital process. Can you please provide some explanation about those software, sir? How would that work?
Yeah. So, you could have... heard about the HIS or EMR or something. So nothing but it's a normal, any hospital may have that basic patient data like age, name, that's a demographic data. Age, name, patient name, age, address and other things. That's called demographic data, including vitals, height, weight, BP, pulse, everything. Also, that's a very basic thing, number one. And second thing, it should be categorized. The telemedicine software should have that categories in the sense of what is the past medical history, what is the present medical history, what is the any image. It should have a separate category in telemedicine software. Also, you should have that, because telemedicine mostly used for that giving or getting opinion. So the software should consist of handling the DICOM, that's image viewing, image transferring, image storing. So for image transferring, the PACS, some of the institution can, the CT scan or MRI machine, they can push that images directly to the your telemedicine software, your software server. So your software should capability to store that images, number one. And second thing, general JPEG format when you transfer, or DICOM format when you transfer your software, that's called telemedicine software, should handle or should consist of that DICOM viewer. Because generally when you see a X-ray, it is in a JPEG format, that is a different, maybe for about 40 kb to up to 1 MB. But the same image, when you convert in the DICOM, it will be nearly for 1 GB. Because the DICOM is very important, the doctors has them, they can read a lot of information when they see the image as a DICOM format, number one. So your software should consist of the basic demographic detail, as well image viewing, look at DICOM, as well with the PACS facility. Also, it should have the HL7 standard. This we are maintaining, there is some standard to be maintained in software, actually. International standard, that's called HL7 standard. Recently, FHIR, F-H-I-R, the recently came into the India also. They standard for our work for each patient record. It should be there on particular categories.
Mike, antenna receiver, as well as antenna mixer, I mean audio mixer.
Madam?
You can see this, is a device.
Madam, Satish sir, teri rara?
Illi, yeah, teri rara. Teri
rara, sir, nilinga.
Ma'am?
If a corrector, sir, you proceed like this only. You're explaining the track, no, for network.
Yeah, I'm showing the rack, ma'am.
Now it's fine. Yeah, you can continue like this, sir.
Sir, this is the satellite receiver. We use it for for ISRO connectivity. This device is called for the video mixer, where you could have seen many cameras can be connected. This capacity has a 6 camera can be connected here, and we can choose the mode, which, for example, you could have seen in that hall or big function like a wedding mahal. One camera can be focusing that couples, newly married couple. Another camera will be reception for focusing. Third one will be the audience. Similarly, this camera can be connected with the mixer, and the output can be chosen by using this mixer. Particular things can be shown. Similarly, this video $10 lakhs, when we now it's reduced to 1.5 lakhs. And second thing, nowadays this kind of video mixer not required. Even that small hardware can be connected in that system itself. By using the software, we can manage. Let me come out from that production control unit. This is that server room. We can say web server, application server, firewall server, backup server with RAS connectivity. And this is that MUX multiplexer for communication line. This capacity about 100 MB. Now it's more than 1 GB can be connected. And let me come out from the telemedicine hall. This is the telemedicine hall. Sir was sitting here and coordinating. Our department is located at the 8th floor of main building. The background, you can see the city. The file, we have a separate room for the systems and other camera. One more PD 120. You can see the beautiful place of city also. And this is the one device for 4 and 5 in 1. So this device can be used for printer, scanner, photocopier, fax machine, as well phone. And this is the server for our telemedicine thing. Apart from that, in one more server at the studio room. It's a video conferencing equipment. Many brands are available, like Sony, Tanberg, Polycom, Huawei, and many more can be connected. The big display systems are there. Video conferencing, this is that video conference, not a video camera, this is a video conferencing camera. So it has that camera unit. The next one will be the codec. That's a base unit, otherwise called codec, we can see. Consists of audio video cables, and HDMI cables can be connected, and the LAN cable for network can be connected, and ISDN cables can be connected. It will be two mess, suppose, if you see the back. And I would like to show you this. This is the Sony video conference camera. Simultaneously, we can connect 6+ centers across the world. It can be connected with IP, internet protocol, static IP can be connected. Also, it has a capacity to connect the ISDN line. You could have studied in the resort 3-3 as well, resort 3-0 protocol. The Polycom camera, again, the MCU is called the multi conferencing unit. This is one more small camera. It's called Sony Handy Camera, TRU-285E model. Just very, even the disk can be used to store that thing. For storing that thing initially, nowadays we don't use that hardware based recording. This is called DVD recorder. Nowadays, that system has that DVD recorder. It's a separate recorder. Both PAL as well NTSL format can be recorded with that great quality. When we bought about 17 years before, only that 8 devices have been imported in Chennai, and one among Ramchandra, just we one among them. This is that, mic receiver, that's a signal receiver, can be connected here, the things. The PhD project they have done. And this is the satellite receiver for registered purpose. This is called Linkstar or Viasa or something we can use. Initially, there are two things. One is for that connectivity, another one is for that antenna tracking. That antenna tracking unit will be there, ACU. Nowadays, the combined, that's even nowadays, it's a more very compact device has come, including for the auto tracking. Auto tracking for the satellite connectivity when you use for the mobile telemetry. And this is for fixed called Viasat. Let me see from the. This is the telemetry. The board where it is mandatory to think. And in the digital support, what are the programs we have that just we can mention here? Very important. I would like to show these are a couple of equipments. You can see here, this is called data solution box. So what you can do, just you can connect the laptop to the camera, video conference camera, by using this data solution box. You can choose, suppose if you want to connect two computers with the one camera, you can choose whether RGB or B something. That's called data solution box for the video conferencing camera. This is a device called ISDN MUX. It's called ISDN MUX. You can see there are six ISDN lines can be connected. The output can be from this one, single output. It can be connected to the video conferencing camera. It costs about 1.25 lakhs when we bought that time. So six ISDN, you could have studied that ISDN line, BRI as well as the PRI. one BRI, I mean that what one line has the two BRI line, 64 into 2. That six lines can be connected out of 128 into 6. You can do that much quality, you can use it. Another one, this is called very simple technology. That's called AV mixer. AV mixer, suppose if you have, you can give that audio video along audio and video to the, this device. Similar kind of device. This is one device. Similar kind of device is there. There are two devices. One is called the sender, another one is for the receiver. You can place an it's for it transmit the data 2.4 gigahertz. You can up to 400 to 500 feet you can use. That is for 130 to 150 meters can be without cables. You can transfer the signals for both audio and video. I studied at ADSL, the router and other things. So kindly bear with this. Sorry, some network issue. Oh, sorry. As you see here in that audio video sender and receiver equipment, very cheap equipment one. It's not that much expensive, but the purpose is very great. And second thing you can, I mentioned there that ISDN NT box. This is called NT box. When you terminate that NT, because it you should have that NT one. That's called. You could have studied
network
standard NT one. It has that two lines. You can connect the two lines and the output can be given, taken.
Input.
Yeah, input. There are two lines can be given. One port is not functioning, you can use another port. That's why they have given two port, and this is the output port. This device is called the NT1 box for terminating the ISDN line. And the second thing, this is a very small video conferencing camera, portable video conferencing camera, because initially that people says, 5 lakhs or 10 lakhs, you have to invest for 5 lakhs or 10 lakhs for the good quality video thing. But a small doctor who are unable to affordable for 5 lakhs or 10 lakhs for the small video conferencing, so they can buy this kind of camera. It has that small inbuilt LCD monitor as well, that camera, inbuilt camera, inbuilt speaker also. But this can be connected. So dial pad, everything will be there. Pip window, everything can be there. And you can mute also. If you want to hide your video, you can mute. Also, this can be extended to the connected to the TV display monitors. So audio video port and network. And this is a digital pad. You can, when you, this is a digital pad. It can be connected to the laptop or system. Suppose if you want to write something, the prescription, e-prescription, people are talking now. So during consultation, if you want to prescribe, how will you prescribe? Usually the latest software or advanced software, they may type it and they can take a printout. But some of the doctor, they are not much techno-savvy to type all these things and which take time. They want to prescribe. So they can use this kind of digital pad as soon as they write. And it can be stored as a normal prescription format, and they can take a printout and they can use it later. Digital pad. These are the omnidirectional mics. There are various categories of mics are available. This is not a unidirectional mic, it's an omnidirectional mic. It can serve for entire 360 degree. With the radius of, with the radius of maybe the distance of about 10 feet to 30 feet, depends upon that acoustic standard what you maintain in your room. And second thing is that the printer. Yeah, one of the student asked me, so what would be our role in future after finish the computer science engineer? As I mentioned, you can develop a software or you can invent a new equipment. This one side network issue. As I mentioned the thing, as soon as you, this is the ECG machine, it can be connected, the Schiller machine, Sandwich model, this device, as soon as you, there are 12 lead ECG machine, as soon as you connect to the patient, it can be transferred, it can be connected to the computer, and it can be transferred online. When you acquire the patient, doctor can see the ECG. The usually ECG has a 12 lead ECG or 6 lead ECG or 2 lead ECG. But since it's at the 12 lead ECG, which will be very useful to them. So you may invite this kind of device instead of that big one, lot of cable. You can, very compact device can be invented by you. I hope many of Panimal Engineering College students may invite a new equipment as well to develop a software. You're entering into the production control. That was in that side, production control unit. This is that where I delivered the lecture from this room only. Yeah, again, this robot, the robo will play a major role in future in telemedicine activity. Because this robo, first time in the Indian scenario, we integrated robo for ICU monitoring. Usually what happens, the doctor, whether cardiologist or neurologist, the senior doctor who is available between 8 o'clock to 4 o'clock, or nurse will make a call to the senior doctor and explain, sir, this is a situation, what to be done, what is the next management. The input given by the junior doctor or the nursing, senior nursing staff at ICU, the doctor gives a treatment, but at the same time, whether the doctor is all the time, you cannot expect the doctor should be there at around the clock in the campus also, or they may have, since they are the human being, they may have that festival, or they may go to out of state or for officially or personally. You cannot expect all these things. At the same time, the doctor is out of country or out of continent, they need not bother about that. Suppose if they have the robo, the robo will be placed or parked at the station at ICU. The doctor accesses the robo to know the present condition of the patient physically as well. They can access the patient's data like from accessing HIS, see the images by using this PDA, personal digital assistant, or even the mobile or iPad, anywhere in the world, whether he is in or she is in America or London or maybe for conference or personal tour. Based on that data available in this robo, he can provide the right treatment. So it's very useful for them. Similarly, one more very important point, since it's had a video conferencing setup in this robo, consider there are three antennas, three kinds of antenna. There are three kinds of antenna. One antenna for one aerial for that video conferencing. Another one is for that movement of it. This one, the third antenna will be connected with the wireless connectivity with the server for accessing transferring images with our HIS system. Also, similarly, this antenna can this robo will be used to for that avoid unnecessary infection, that's the nosocomial infection between the patient and the patient. We cannot allow the restricted. Suppose if they have a robo, since it has a video conference camera, this robo can be moved from the one patient to another patient the patient attender can ask the patient attender to come out to some other room. They can interact with the nurse to know the what is the person status of that patient. That is also another utilization. So that we can save lot of inspection rate in the time. Thank you.
That's all, sir.
Yeah, that's all, sir. Anything you want to ask?
No. Students, if you have any question, I think, sir, his visit is over. Very good explanation, and I think it's a marvelous session for us. Okay. Vinmadi, madam.
Yes, sir. Okay, sir.
Let me go for the end of the session, madam.
Okay, sir. Sir, on behalf of the management,
one second. Yes, sir. Yaar ka doubts students, you have any doubts? Students, regarding equipments. Rukkareng, sir. Okay.
Can I proceed?
This is what our session. Thank you. My name, sir. Madam, Vinmadi, madam.
Yes, sir.
Vinmadi, madam.
Yes, sir. I'm here.
Raj Kumar. Thanks for leading.
Okay, sir. Sir, on behalf of the management, our HOD, Mrs. Jabashila ma'am, Mr. Sendil Kumar sir, Mr. Sashi Kumar sir, so they have organized this virtual visit to Sri Ramachandra Medical College. So I am very grateful to Dr. Satish Kumar sir, head telemedicine, who has given various concepts related to role of telemedicine in Sri Ramachandra, and about the patient's care. Then the benefits of telemedicine, then the different applications of telemedicine, then academic programs related to Sri Ramachandra across Kanyakumari to Kashmir. Then he told about various research and training, teledentistry, telenursing, and the Indian scenario and the global perspective. So, and also a virtual visit relating to Sri Ramachandra telemedicine, sir. So I thank Mr. Rajkumar sir also to has given shown various equipments and explained and his explanation. Thank you, sir. Thank you once again for this wonderful opportunity for the third year students who has done only the theoretical part. So it has given a lot of insight to them, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, madam.
Thank you, sir.
Madam. Sheila, madam. Madam, anything you want to convey, madam? HOD, madam.
HOD, ma'am is there.
Madam, good morning, madam.
Hello, sir. Good morning, sir.
Ma'am, good morning.
Sir, on behalf of our Panimala Engineering College and my department and my own behalf, I would like to thank you, sir. Thank you, Sadhis. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Thanks for giving an opportunity. And I hope, since it's a very vast area, in fact, you could have stayed the 45 hours in the 5 unit. I have touched the glimpses about telemedicine. Because as I mentioned, the telemedicine is a very vast area as well. Future medicine will be telemedicine. Various projects have been taken by Tom Chandra. I cannot finish in 1 hour or 2 hour session. There is a lot of things are there in telemedicine, and the only missing, just we couldn't give you any practical session because it's currently that function is going on. I mean, Puja Festival is going on Northeast. Usually we can connect Kolkata, Siliguri, or Guwahati, or Agartala, I can connect. Since yesterday, they started the Puja Festival for 10 days, unable to connect though. And really, we're missing you all, students and the doctor, faculty at our telemedicine. Usually, that's traditionally we do with the many medical institution. And fortunately, you have 300, surprising, about 300 plus students are there in your department alone. It's like a mini engineering college. That's very nice to know that. In future, I would like to, first of all, I would like to give an impression to the students. We need, the students should develop a software. They can come to the telemedicine field by inviting, by inventing new equipments, ma'am. We may tie up for future collaboration for inventing new equipment or software development or any other future telemedicine projects.
Interesting, sir. I'm going to disconnect.
Others are there.
Satish sir, thank you so much from our side, sir. I'm Sheila.
Yes, madam.
And hopefully you can offer some project, real-time projects to our students, sir. And students, those are interested, you can contact Sendil Kumar, sir, and get to know on what projects you can work in association with Dr. Selva Kumar also. Okay, sir, neurosurgeon, nalarkangla, sir.
Fine, ma'am.
Okay, sir. Convey my regards to sir also.
Yeah, certainly, ma'am. Certainly.
Okay. And thank you so much, sir. This is an innovative method which was started by you and Sendil Kumar, sir, and other professors in this subject in delivering the facilities in your unit to the students, even though they are not able to visit it personally. Okay, you have shown all the equipments which will provide them with some knowledge on how to start their work in this area of telemedicine, which is still evolving and developing. And I hope they will develop some projects or some services which can be useful to the society in the future. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you, madam. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Sendil sir, Sasi Kumar sir, for initiating this effort.
Thank you, Sasi, also joining with us, madam.
Yeah, that's what I told. Thank you to Sasi Kumar sir and Sendil Kumar sir.
Thank you, madam.
For taking this initiative.
Thank you, madam. Thank you, all my dear students, and particularly Vinmadi madam and Anita madam. Madam, thank you, madam.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
On behalf of the Institution Telemedicine Department, I thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. There is no class
thank
hereafter.
You, very innovative question, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, madam. There is no class hereafter. They are joining to the next day program. That is tomorrow classes only.
Okay.
Thank you, all students. Thank you. Bye.
Students, thank you. So today's session with that, we'll be getting it wind up.
Thank you, ma'am.
Tomorrow we'll be having it with your as usual class.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yes, thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, sir.
Yes, leave fast. Leave the meeting fast. I'll leave fast. Yes, you can leave. leave the meeting. 371. Ishan. Sivadhanuj, Satish. Jashwan. Deepika, Alagudurai, Vishal, 387, 72, 102, 170, leave.